Through community development and livelihood programs, the barangay development and enhanced comprehensive local integration programs have been effective in addressing the root cause of conflict in the countryside. To complete this reintegration process, I will issue a proclamation granting amnesty to rebel returnees, and I ask Congress to support me in this endeavor. Our journey to progress requires imperative that our nation remains intact and inviolable, our sovereignty preserved. We will protect our sovereign rights and preserve our territorial integrity in defense of a rules-based international order. With our national interest paramount, we will always pursue constant dialogue and diplomatic approaches to the resolution of any issue that may arise. So the initial results of our efforts inspire confidence. Let us continue to be relentless in our aspiration of peace and progress. This has not been the work of a single person, neither a single branch of government, nor even the whole government acting alone. This is the collective synergy achieved by all Filipinos working together. It took a whole-of-nation effort to achieve this immediate recovery from our pandemic slump. Unity was what made us rise once more. Nagsisimula pa lamang tayo. Ang pagbangon ng ating bayan ay magpapatuloy pa. Hinihiling ko ang inyong tiwala at pakikiisa. Sa ganitong paraan, makakamtan natin ang ating tanging hangarin, ang maginhawa, matatag at panatag na buhay para sa lahat ng Pilipino. Makikipagtulungan tayo ng mabuti sa Kongreso para sa mga mahalagang batas na kinakailangan para sa ating tuloy-tuloy na pag-ahon. And once again, I appeal to Congress for its support for the following priority legislations. The essential tax measures under our medium-term fiscal framework, such as excise tax on single-use plastics, VAT on digital services, rationalization of mining fiscal regime, motor vehicle users charge, road users tax, the military and uniform personnel pension, amendment of the Fisheries Code, amendment of the Anti-Agricultural Smuggling Act, amendment of the Cooperative Code, new government procurement law, new government auditing code, anti-financial account scamming, Tatak Pinoy law, the blue economy law, ease of paying taxes, LGU income classification, and the Philippine Immigration Act.